Celiac disease affects the small bowel, and it makes it so that the body doesn't absorb nutrients quite as well. It can affect individuals from infancy all the way through adulthood, and it occurs in approximately one in every 133 Americans, so about 1% of the population has celiac disease. The signs and symptoms can vary quite significantly from one person to the next. In some people, you can have diarrhea, in others, you can have constipation. You can have weight loss or weight gain. Oftentimes, you have abdominal pain or belly pain, and it's very hard to tell based upon just symptoms alone. The first way that we test for celiac disease is getting a blood sample. This can screen, but the ultimate way that we can diagnose celiac disease is by doing an upper endoscopy, where we take samples of skin from inside the GI tract to look for celiac disease. For babies, they obviously can't tell us that they're having belly pain, but we look for kids who have lots of spitting up or reflux, if they're having problems with growth, if they're having difficulties with gaining weight. Any of these things could give us a clue that we might need to screen for celiac disease. You have to avoid all items that contain gluten. And gluten, unfortunately, is in many, many foods. And that's why we have you work with our dietitian so that you can go through and find all of the different hidden sources of gluten. There aren't any medicines that you need to use. If you make the change in your diet, you'll be able to treat the celiac disease.